everyone, this is Dawn, and welcome back to my channel, and welcome back to the very final installment of the Christmas and summer collaboration. I have to thank each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart to everyone that has participated in this collaboration to make it such a spectacular event. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your wonderful projects, your amazing creativity, and the sense of community. I appreciate you guys so very much. I'm sure you all have seen projects going up all day long. Oh my goodness, I am just blown away. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So if you haven't already, make sure to check out the description box below for everyone that is participating. There are many on YouTube, and of course, a great handful on Instagram. And then we've had some other folks come along and join in as well. And I'm just amazed. So you can put in the search bar, hashtag Christmas and Summer, and you will find video after video, and then over on Instagram as well. So make sure you check everyone out there. And again, thank you, thank you, thank you for all of you guys that are watching and commenting. I appreciate you guys so much, and for subscribing as well. Oh my goodness. Thank you, everyone, for making this a wonderful, creative event and the wonderful sense of community. I love this crafty community, and I love you guys. And I've been missing being here. So there's been a lot of things keeping me out of my craft room lately. Things are okay. We're just going through a season of life. A lot of things around my mom and her health. And right now it is raining, if you hear it. The craft porch with the aluminum ceiling. There is some good old-fashioned floor. Florida rain happening right now, and there's been some rain causing some damage to her home. She's right now living with me for the foreseeable future. We're just kind of going, you know, doing the thing, doing the life. So it's a joy and a pleasure to be back in the craft room. I have to tell you, it's been a very long, busy day, and I know I am bringing up the tail here with my video. We can post any time on Saturday, so I like am scooching in here at the final moments. So with this being the final week, I thought I would offer up a giveaway. So the only rules are you must be, I would appreciate you being a subscriber. You must be 18 years of age or older and live in the United States. I hate saying that, but I know you guys all understand with all the shipping costs and all of that. Today is August 22nd, and I don't want you to really talk about a giveaway down in the comments, but use the word jolly in your comment. And if you want to enter, use the word jolly when you comment, and Tuesday is the 25th. Christmas is December 25th. I'm going to come back on the evening of August 25th and draw a random winner using the random comment picker and using the keyword jolly. So that is what I'm going to do. So I've got this Holly Jolly collection. I saw Chris Lawlor use this collection on her very first week. I'm going to go ahead and link it down in the description box below, because why not? What an adorable collection. And oh my goodness, she made some adorable cards with this. And then not long after that, I saw this offered up on Peachy Cheap. So I went ahead and picked it up, and then I decided, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and offer this. So this is the wonderful paper pad. So along with the reds and greens, you've got these wonderful blues and cut aparts, just adorable. And then there's a little sticker kit, and there are ephemera pieces, some fun little paper clip bows, and some chipboard stickers. So those are the rules. I'm gonna reiterate those down in the description box below, and I'm gonna come back and draw a winner on August 25th on Tuesday evening. So stay tuned for that and use the word jolly in your comment. All right, so without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and share my little project for this final week, and I hope you can hear me over this rain. My goodness. So I really had a hard time deciding what I was gonna do, and I was going through a box of scraps that I used last Christmas, and I pulled this bingo card out, and it's a vintage bingo card I got off of eBay once upon a time, and then I found a little scrap of ribbon. I found this gingerbread journaling card that I just trimmed down a little bit, and I have used some glitter glue and some stickles just to give it some shine, added some stickles in the corners of my card, and I added a little sticker. I think this came from Target once upon a time. I have been looking for this rubber stamp this entire collaboration, and I opened up a drawer this evening and bam, there it was. This is really old. I got this off of eBay once upon a time. It's a 2006 Rubber Cottage, and it fits in this tiny little tag punch. This is an older Martha Stewart one. I use it a ton. I've had it for years, and so I just love this, and I just kind of wanted to have a collage type of effect. I was thinking about adding a bow down here as well, which I might, but this is something that can be turned into a card. It can be used as a tag. It can be tucked into a journal, and I actually would like to create some more, maybe in a little bit more collage style, some vintage type of things, but this is my little gingerbread share. It's a little bit of a nod to Pink Christmas, which I adore. So this is my project share. So once again, I would love it if you would leave this comment a this video a thumbs up. Would love it if you would subscribe. Comment if you would like to enter. And again, reminder of the rules will be down in the description box below. All right, guys, make sure you are checking out all of the wonderful ladies again in this collaboration, and once again, thank you. I know I'm rambling on. I will see you guys next time. Merry Christmas.